Good morning, teachers. Good morning, Mr. Ng, and fellow classmates. Today, we are presenting to you about our social studies project, which is on Chapter 2, The Wonders of Southeast Asia. Our team members are me, Chia, Leong, Bharath, Surya, Razaele, Zerui, and Htite. Chia, Leong will now start the presentation.
I am presenting to you the differences between natural and man-made wonders in Southeast Asia. Natural wonders have cleaner water, healthier air, better soil for agriculture and protection from diseases like landslide, whereas man-made wonders have no protection from any disasters. Natural wonders are fit by biodiversity, used to educate the public about the importance of nature, whereas man-made wonders have no protection from flora. Now pass the time to Bharath.
I am now going to talk about how the preservation of these wonders can benefit future generations. Southeast Asia is a rich and diverse region where we can find many remarkable sites and monuments. Not only are these wonders beautiful, they also represent legacies from the past. I will now talk to you about Ha Long Bay. Please watch the video.
By the superintendent.
Rising sharply above the base shallow waters. most of the islands and islets do not have people living on them, as their slopes are so steep. The dramatic landscape of limestone towers, which made it popular travel destinations. I'm also going to talk to you about Ulu Tamburung National Park. Ulu Tamburung National Park was the first national park to be established in Brunei, protected since 1991. The park is in Tamburung district in eastern Brunei and covers about 40% of the district in the south at 550 square kilometers. The park contains unspoiled jungle and is also known as the Green Jewel of Brunei. Described as the finest example as the Sultan's successful forest protected by policy, it is an important ecotourism center in Brunei and hosts the Ulu Resort. The Bharadayan Forest Reserve is also located in the district. Now I'll pass the time to Surya.
Talk about Tonosat Lake. Tonosat Lake is the largest freshwater lake. It's the largest freshwater lake in Cambodia, protected by UNESCO due to the lake's unique flora and fauna. The Lower Mekong Basin experiences two monsoon periods, rainy from May to October, and a dry season from November to March. The annual rainfall is between 1,000 and 3,000 mm, locally up to 4,000 millimeters, falling almost entirely during the rainy season. Water levels reach their highest in September and October. The lake is an important commercial resource, providing more than half of the fish consumed in Cambodia. In total, 80,000 people live on the water permanently, spread out over 170 floating villages. Their living conditions are tough and they earn less than $500 a year. I will also talk about Tata Mailau. Tata Mailau or Tata Mailau, sometimes referred as Mount Ramelau, is the highest mountain in East Timor and also of Timor Island at 2,986 meters. The name Tata Mailau is Mumbai origin. The local language means grandfather of all. The Tata Mailau is dedicated to Virgin Mary and the subject of an annual pilgrimage commemorating the Annunciation of the Blessed Virgin Mary on or around 25th March. There is a 3 meter high statue of the Virgin Mary on the peak, which came from Italy and was erected during Indonesian occupation in 1997. December is warmest with an average temperature of 19.4 degrees Celsius at noon. August is coldest with an average temperature of 8.9 degrees Celsius at night. Tata Mailau has no distinct temperature seasons. The temperature is relatively constant during the year. There are not much people living there. On average, there are only 76 people per kilometer square. I will now pass my time to Razaele.
About Lake Toba. Lake Toba is a large natural lake occupying the caldera of the Himalayas. The lake is about 100 kilometers long, 30 kilometers wide, and up to 505 meters deep. It is the largest lake in Indonesia and also the largest volcanic lake in the world. Lake Toba is the site of a massive super volcanic eruption that happened around 59,000 to 77,000 years ago, representing a climate-changing event. It is the largest known explosive eruption on Earth in the last 25 million years. Most of the people who live around Lake Toba are ethnically Bastam. Traditional Bastam cultures are noted for their distinctive blue, which curve upwards at its hand like the wolf color, and their colorful decor. I will also talk about Indogi Lake Wildlife Sanctuary. Indogi Lake Wildlife Sanctuary is a wildlife reserve of Burma, Myanmar. It is located in Mungin Township in Kachin State. It occupies an area of 775 km² and was established in 1999. The region is home to rare bird species and other wild animals, including wild elephants, bunting with grass, rare gibbon species, and forest birds. The predominant ethnic groups living in the surroundings of the lake are the Sha and the Kachin, who mainly practice agriculture. I will now pass my time to Zerui.
I will now talk about Tang Kong Lo. Tang Kong Lo or Kong Lo Cave is a karst limestone cave in Bang National Park in Khao-Mei-Rapids, Laos. It is located around 130 km north of Htite. On the dam, the Bang River, it flows into the cave. The karst formation is dramatic and the cave has been cited as one of Southeast Asia's geological wonders. Inside the cave is a pool which glows a bright amber color which locals hold as sacred, believing it to reflect the skin of the drinking god. I will also talk about Taman Negara. Taman Negara was established at the TT Wangsan Complex, Malaysia in 1938 or 1939 as the King George V National Park. It was renamed to Taman Negara after independence, which culturally means National Park. It has a reputation as the world's oldest tropical rainforest, estimated to be more than 130 million years old. The park has been developed into a famous ecotourism destination in Malaysia and there are several geological and biological attractions to the park. Taman Negara is also home to one of Malaysia's Aboriginal groups, the Bata. As other oral ethnic or original people, they traditionally led a nomadic lifestyle in the forest, hunting game with bullpipes. In recent years, they have been settled by the government and villagers, and visits to these settlements have been arranged. Now, we'll pass the time to Zeyu.
I will now talk about Thorough Princess Severn River National Park. The Thorough Princess Severn River National Park is a protected area of the Philippines, located about 80 km north of the city center of Puerto Princesa, Palawan. One of the river's distinguishing features is that it emerges directly into the sea, and its lower portion is subject to tidal influences. The river also represents a significant habitat for biodiversity conservation. The sea contains a full mountain to sea system and some of the most important forests in Asia. Now pass the time to my type.
I will now talk about Bukit Timah Nature Reserve. The Bukit Timah Nature Reserve is a small 1.64 square kilometer nature reserve near the geographic center of the city state of Singapore. Located on the slopes of Bukit Timah Hill, Singapore's highest hill standing at a height of 163.63 meters, and parts of the surrounding area. Today, it is one of the largest patches of primary rainforest left in Singapore. The forest reserve was formally declared as an ASEAN Heritage Park on 18 October 2011.
Bukit Timah was one of the first forest reserves established in 1883. By 1937, the forest reserves were depleted under economic pressure for development. I will also talk about Khao Sok National Park. Khao Sok National Park is in Surat Thani province, Thailand. Its area is 739 square kilometers, and it includes the 165 square kilometers Cholan Lake, contained by the Ratchaprakpa Dam. The park is the largest area of virgin forest in southern Thailand, and is a remnant of rainforest, which is older and more diverse than the Amazon rainforest. It is among Thailand's wettest regions, with an annual rainfall of 3,500 millimeters. The park is estimated to contain over 5% of the world's species. Wild mammals include Malayan tapir, Asian elephant, tiger, sambar deer, bear, gua, banteng, zero, gua boar, pintail macaque, langur, white-headed gibbon squirrel, munjak, mouse deer, and barking deer. Thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you. Rock is an apple.